Great. So let's move to our next speaker, Sara El-Ghaili from Budapest University of Technology and Economics. Sara, welcome.
Hi. Welcome.
Thanks a lot. So Sara will talk about constrained quantum optimization strategy. Looking forward to it, Sara. Over to you.
Okay. Hello. So my name is Sara. Thank you for your coming here today. I would like to thank the organizer for their efforts and help in organizing this event. So my work is entitled Constrained Quantum Optimization Strategy. So as it is now, classical computing still suffer from a high computational complexity for finding the extreme value of a constrained goal function. One of these reasons is that the function may is non-continuous, or the function is non-monotonic, and sometimes the constrained goal function has many local extreme values satisfying the constraint, or the database is insorted. So for this sake, we come up with the idea to develop a new constrained quantum strategy. So the background to understand this new method are as follows: quantum phase estimation, quantum counting, quantum existence testing, binary searching algorithm, and quantum extreme value searching algorithm. So as it is now, quantum phase estimation is computes the exact value of theta, which is the phase of the eigenvalue of a unitary matrix, and the quantum counting algorithm finds the number of occurrences m of a searched item in insorted database, while the quantum existence testing is a special case of a quantum counting algorithm. It tells us just whether the searched item exists or not in the database. Now for the binary searching algorithm, as it is now, it finds the searched item or a value in sorted database, while the quantum extreme value searching algorithm, it finds the extreme value of an unconstrained goal function or an in sorted database. And it combines the binary searching algorithm and the quantum existence testing. Before we introduce the constrained quantum optimization algorithm, let's first define what are the index register, what is the database. So as you see here, so the database, it has the index register, and it's, every index register has a database value. And here, the index register, what we do is that we present the index register on an x-axis, where this the unit scale of this x-axis is 1, and the database values on a y-axis. And the unit scale of this y-axis is computed as follows. You see? Alpha. So, and this is what we did. So this is how the presentation of the units of the x-axis values and the y-axis values. So now, there was a step that we did before we introduced the continuous and the non-continuous database, is that we convert the database values of y-axis from the original scale, which is alpha, to the unit scale, which is unit scale 1. So you see here, so we just change the. Now let's move to define what that means, continuous database and non-continuous database. So a database is a being continuous if the difference between the database y plus 1 minus database y equal 1 or 0, while it is non-continuous if it is if the this difference is different than 0 or 1. So here, as you see, I give an example. For example, here the database is continuous. So the difference of every two database index register equal 1. While here, I try to remove these red circles from here. So as you see here, it is non-continuous. So here I give also to just an explanation what does mean an extreme value, quantum extreme value search and algorithm, and the working mechanism of this algorithm, because many people cannot know how it works. So here I give an example how to find the minimum value of an unconstrained goal function. So here, as you see, I have the function. So what we do is that the database is divided into two, and then we apply the quantum existence testing function. If there exists an item, so we go to the logwork part, and then if we do the same thing, the same procedure, the same steps when we are searching in, and we are applying the QET every time we are making the division until we find the optimum results. Now we will move to explain what is the constraint quantum optimization algorithm. So as I explained earlier, quantum extreme value searching algorithm, first it can perform only the search in a continuous database, it can just only in the continuous database, and it cannot handle the constrained goal functions. This is the two bottlenecks of this algorithm. So to enhance the search capabilities of the quantum extreme value searching algorithm, we extend the functionalities of the quantum existing system to a new version, which is called constrained quantum relation system. And what we do with this constrained quantum relation system, we combine it with the binary searching algorithm, and we give a birth to a new algorithm, which is called constrained quantum optimization algorithm. So what is this CQRT, this extended version of QET? So it gives back an only an answer whether there exists at least one or more database entries with respect to the applied relation of the reference ref and the constraint C in a certain region of the database. One of you may ask me, what is the computational complexity of this quantum method? So to calculate it, we need to investigate the classical and the quantum uncertainty of the CQRT. So the total number of qubits needed for the application depend on the classical accuracy and the quantum certainty. And as the quantum existence testing function work with the QE, with the quantum uses in a discrete way the quantum phase estimation, also the CQRT uses the quantum phase estimation in discrete. And the assumption that we were based on is that involving the constraint and the relation will not modify the conversion of the quantum phase estimation. So the calculation of the evaluation of the classical accuracy and the quantum uncertainty will not influence the calculation of the total number of qubits. Here I didn't include the demonstration, so I tried to transform it to this way in order to be. So that it's the is to sum up, the computational complexity of the QET is equal to the CQRT. And this is the computational complexity. Why? Because involving the relation R and the constraint will not influence the classical and the quantum uncertainty of the CQRT. So now let's move to define the constrained quantum optimization algorithm. As I already said, the binary search the constrained quantum optimization algorithm combine the binary the well-known binary searching algorithm and the constrained quantum relation system. So this constrained quantum relation system allow the binary searching algorithm to work in an unconstrained database, and also it opened the possibility to work to handle the constraint case. This is the quantum algorithm. So as you see here, we have the binary searching algorithm combined with the CQRC function. And here, as you see, this is the computational complexity of the CQOA. So it is log to t, log to 3, square root n, which is very, very low computational complexity. So here I give an example of how to find the minimum value of a constraint growth function. Here we divide the database into two regions, and we go lower, and then we apply the CQRT. Then we do the same procedure, but the working mechanism of the CQRT is different than the QET. So here the CQRT work for a region, but the QET work for a certain value. So as a conclusion, I extend the quantum existence testing method to CQRT method, and I extend the quantum external value searching algorithm to a new version, which is called CQOA. And the computational complexity, as you see, it is very, very low. And one last thing for the future work, we would like to implement the constraint quantum optimization algorithm in a resource distribution management with considering Q-win scenarios. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Sara. Excellent talk. So unfortunately, we don't have time for questions for Sara. We need to move to the final speaker. So thank you very much.
You're welcome. Bye.